exercise is good for our hearts, but did you know it helps you sleep better too, Reg?
I had no idea.
I know you did. Here with the A to Z's of sleep and exercise is Dr. Tiffany Sizemore, a board-certified cardiologist. That's the way I like my cardiologist, specializing in preventative medicine. Hello, doctor.
Good morning.
So tell us what we're doing here in bed, like Ricky and Lucy.
So what we're talking about today is the importance of exercise and helping you sleep. Because what's happening now is we have a lot of professionals, a lot of people in TV, and they're having issues sleeping at night. For more than one reason. They're anxious, they can't turn their brains off, they have insomnia. You were just saying that you takes you forever to fall asleep.
Until three in the morning, right.
And we know that exercise, especially about 30 minutes a day, any form of exercise helps us sleep at
night.
But
I do that.
He does that every day, never misses the gym. So this is a new phenomenon for him. So this is a problem, right?
Yes.
See, I can fall asleep just fine, but I can't stay asleep.
So exercise helps that too.
I do it too every single day, but I do it like at 2 in the afternoon.
And the other thing we were saying, you know, prior to coming on is that light therapy is very important. So in the morning when you wake up, you want bright light, open the shades, open everything in the house, get the sunlight. When you're driving to work, don't put on your sunglasses. And when you're driving home, reset that kind of circadian clock. Tell your body it's time to go to bed, put on your sunglasses, turn down the lights in the house so you can start setting that clock again.
What time do you go to bed?
I go to bed around 11.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
And what time do you wake up?
Around 6.
No kidding.
And you don't get up to go to the bathroom or anything.
I don't have a prostate.
I don't have a prostate either.
You don't? I never knew that.
If I could get myself to guarantee a good night's sleep, I'd get a prostate.
Well, we have also some yoga moves that we're going to practice.
Oh, crap.
That help us stretch.
Right.
So help us calm down and get ready for bed.
Come on, Reg.
All right. Let's do it.
All right.
We don't need the weights.
We don't need the weights.
Okay.
Why are they there? Okay. Thank you.
So the first one.
Can we take the...
You can take your robes off.
Want to take your robe off, miss?
Why?
Hold on. I'll step out of the screen for this one.
Why am I still wearing this one?
All righty, Dr. Sizemore.
Okay. Doctor.
All right. We're going to kneel down.
All right.
And you're going to kind of
place... These are heavy.
You're going to place your butt on your heels.
Uh-huh.
And then you bend forward.
Nice Louboutins.
Thank you.
Cardiology is doing well. Okay.
You good, Reg?
I think so. I don't know.
Okay, tuck your toes under, Reg. Tuck your toes.
Tuck your toes under.
There you go.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, we're going to lean forward, and our arms go forward with us, and it's called child's pose.
Yeah, I like child's pose. It's so comfortable.
Reg, don't break a hip. Okay.
Okay.
All right, straight forward, and then we take a big deep breath in and out. And that helps turn our mind off and calm down before bed.
I want to go night-night right now.
So you do this before you go to bed.
Before you go to bed.
Okay, what after this?
The next one is called the corpse pose because you look like a corpse. So you just lie flat on your back.
You're going to make a prettier corpse than me, so I'm going to let you do it. Watch your head, honey. Sorry.
Like this.
Wow.
Big deep breath in.
We're going to go to
look
commercial break right now.
Look at Regis.
How to feed your family for under 20
look
bucks.
At look at Regis.
Look at Regis. I feel better already.
With two delicious dinners. It's a zoo around here. Can't wait for the animals. Dave Mitajewski and Rob Shute is here. My gosh, what a day.
Doctor, I need help. Please help me.